Dear learner, I hope you have kept yourself safe and you have stayed home. And you have also kept yourself useful by helping your parents. Please don't forget to wash your hands regularly with soap and water. My name is Byaruhanga Bonaventure. Together with my colleague Livingstone from Ugandan Sign Language, we are going to have a chemistry lesson, and our topic is the periodic table. I repeat, our topic is the periodic table. Now, let us get started. During this lesson, we shall understand what the periodic table is. We shall also understand how elements are classified in the periodic table. Two things. One, to understand what the periodic table is. And two, to understand how elements are classified on the periodic table. Right, very good. Let us look at it this way. In our houses, we have objects made of glass, we have plastic, we have ceramic. Some people call them clay. That one shouldn't disturb you. But we have glass, we have plastic, we have ceramic. Which other one? Oh, good, metallic. Metallic. Now, how do you put these ones in groups? Maybe plates, cups, glass, such a things. You will find out that those objects in the house which have some kind of similarities can be put together. For example, plates, cups, and glasses. That's one way of putting them together in groups this way. All of the materials made out of plastic, put them together. Materials made out of clay, put them together. Materials made out of metal, put them together. Materials made out of glass, put them together. In other words, we are depending on certain features or characteristics. Or if I were to put it, similarities. Let us look at another example. People from one family may differ from members from another family. For example, from one family, all of the members may be very tall, or maybe they may be brown. Then another family, there are certain things you may look at and say, okay, this one belongs to the other family, this one belongs to another family. These are features. In the same way, elements are quite many in number, and they don't have everything similar. There are certain features or characteristics which we can use so that we put them into different groups. Different groups where some elements are similar. My dear learner, do you remember the meaning of an element? Can you name some of the elements? Very good. I hope you studied elements in senior one. Let us name a few together. We have oxygen, we have sodium, we have hydrogen, we have lithium, we have calcium, we have nitrogen. Which other two? And we stop. Oh, nice. Magnesium is also there. Aluminium is also there. Very good. These are just a few of the elements, but they don't have the same characteristics or features. They differ in some way. So we need to put them into categories such that those which are similar in a way appear together. And in this way, that classification, which puts elements of certain similar features together, is in form of a table, which is called the periodic table. All right, I believe we understand that. That the periodic table is that classification of elements, such that those elements of similar features appear together. Thank you so much. Now, let me give you a small exercise. Dear learner, do we know how to draw a table? Oh, yes. Let us draw in our notebook, either using a pen or using a pencil, a small table which has four rows, the horizontal lines, all of the horizontal boxes, four rows, and six vertical boxes or six columns. Now, I hope you are doing it or you have finished doing it. Elements are classified in a table similar to the one you have drawn. And that is what is called the periodic table, if elements are fitted in. Nice. We are going to see how to fit these elements in that kind of table to form a periodic table. All right. Let us go back to the table that we have drawn. We are going to label all the columns, the vertical ones, on top with Roman numerals, but in capital letters. Do you remember Roman numerals? Yes, I think so. You did that one in primary school mathematics. The Roman numerals. And we shall label only six. We shall only label six on top of each of the columns. Are we ready? Let us start. One, that's for the first column. Two, for the second column, that's II in Roman. Three, for the third column. Four, for the fourth column. Five, for the fifth column. What is five in Roman numerals, by the way? It is V. Good. And then six, for the sixth column, which is VI. Now, we have formed six columns. We have labeled six columns. On the periodic table, Those ones are called groups. Dear Lana, I believe we are now trying to understand what the periodic table looks like. So we have groups, the vertical columns. We have labeled six groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Those are groups. We are going to see how do elements in each group behave. What features or characteristics are there? Very interesting. We are going to use only two elements. The common ones which you saw in senior one and whose symbols you remember very well. Now, one of them is lithium. And for the symbol, what is the symbol? Good. Capital L-O-I. Capital L-O with small I. The atomic number is 3 in figures. Atomic number is 3 in figures. The other element is sodium. And for the symbol, we have capital N and small a. Capital N and small a. Have you written that one? Oh, good. Atomic number is 11 in figures. Atomic number is 11 in figures. All right. I believe that before this lesson, you have studied electron configuration. We have studied electron configuration. So, let us write the electron configuration for lithium and sodium. Let us write the electron configuration for lithium and sodium. All right, do you remember how to write electron configuration? Good. For lithium, we have 3 electrons because the number of electrons is equal to the number of protons or atomic number. The same applies to sodium. So, if we have to write the electron configuration of lithium, we write 2 full colons or dot dot as you want it, and then 1. So 2:1. Then for sodium, we write 2:8:1. I hope we are moving on well. So, dear learner, what is common in these two electron configurations? Is there any similarity? Yes. All of them end in 1. All of them end in 1. That means that they have one electron in the outermost shell. In the outermost shell, one electron. So that is a similarity. In other words, lithium and sodium will be put in the same group. They belong to the same group of the periodic table. So we have started filling our periodic table. The number of electrons in the outermost shell is the same as the group number. It's the same as the group number. I am repeating that. So how many electrons are in the outermost shell? For lithium and for sodium. Very good. There is one. There is one. So lithium and sodium belong to group one in the periodic table. This is very interesting. We can know the group number for every element by writing its electron configuration. Yeah, that's it. Let us now try this example. We have three elements and we have given them names. There is X, there is Y, there is Z. Their atomic numbers are 4 for X, 8 for Y, and 12 for Z. Now, which of those elements are found in the same group of the periodic table? Which of those? Let us try. We shall write electron configurations for each element. Remember that the number of electrons is equal to the number of protons, which is the same as atomic number. So, for X, atomic number we said before, electron configuration is 2, then dot dot 2. For Y, atomic number we said 8, so that is electron configuration is 2 dot dot 6. Good. And for Z, atomic number of 12, electron configuration is 2 dot dot 8 dot dot 2. Wonderful. So X and Z have something common. Electron configurations end in 2. So what does that mean? They are in the same group. of the periodic table. Which group? Very nice. Group 2. So, we shall use the same knowledge to identify the group for the elements that we talk about, that we know. Dear Lana, let me remind you that during this lesson, we have understood what the periodic table is, and also understood the features, one of them the groups, and how we form groups, or how we understand which elements belong to certain groups in the periodic table. In the next lesson, we shall understand how the horizontal rows are filled. But a small dose here for you, the horizontal rows are called periods. We shall see how periods are identified. Thank you so much for being very wonderful learners. This lesson was extracted from the Senior 2 Chemistry syllabus. Please stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.